Let's start out with what I like to call the quick and dirty import settings. This is a good place to start if you're new to importing in Lightroom. I'll begin by clicking on Import on the bottom left, and I'm going to be importing from an SD card that I've plugged into my computer. I can see that in the source here, it's called Untitled. I just haven't given the card a name yet. You have another option here, Eject After Import. This will automatically eject that card once you finish your import process. It's up to you whether or not you want to have that checked. I like to keep mine unchecked. Now let's move up to the top. We have Copy as DNG, Copy, Move, or Add. Because I'm importing these from a card, I'm only given two options. If you're not sure about DNG yet, don't worry about it. Just select Copy. This will copy the photos over in their existing raw form, which is great. Just below that, we have New Photos selected, and this is going to be a very common option. I use this one all the time. Usually I'm importing photos from a card where I've already imported some of the photos that are already on it. In this case, I am actually going to select only a grouping of these images. First, I'm going to go down to the bottom, and I'm going to sort them by capture time so I can see them a little more clearly and have them grouped into the order that I actually photographed them. And then I'll select Uncheck All at the bottom. I'm going to click on one of the photos, scroll down, hold the Shift key and click again, and then click inside of that little checkbox to select only those highlighted images. Now only the photos that you see checked are going to import into Lightroom. Now let's go over to the right. I'll start out with file handling. You really don't have to worry about this section if you're not sure what any of these mean. The default settings are going to be just fine, and in most cases, it's what I use on a regular basis. For file renaming, you probably will want to rename your file. I don't like to keep them as is. They just are messy and they don't really mean anything to me. So I'll click on that Rename Files box, and I prefer to use custom name and original file number. Use whatever system you like that makes the most sense to you. And in the sample section, you can see a preview of what your files are going to look like. In the Apply During Import section, go ahead and just leave this blank if you're not sure about it. If you already have a metadata preset, you can select it from this list. Otherwise, just leave it as is, and you can make these changes after the fact if you'd like to. The destination is an important section to pay attention to. The default is going to import them by date, but for me, this type of organization doesn't really make a lot of sense to my brain. And your choice of organization is really just going to be up to you. I'm going to change this into one folder, and then I'm going to locate the folder that I'd like to use. For the purpose of this tutorial, I'm going to add these into a folder on the desktop. But for you, you're probably going to want to import your files into an external hard drive. I have my main folder selected, and then I'll check on Into Subfolder and give it a new name. I'm finished making all my changes, so I'll go ahead and click Import to start the import of these files.